Welcome back and welcome to the second session where we're going to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of computer systems. There is an overwhelming awareness that there is a great potential in the availability and use of computer technology. In spite of this observation about the potential benefits of using computer technologies, there are also demerits for using these technologies. This session seeks to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of computer systems. Now, at the end of this session, the student will be able to identify some of the advantages and disadvantages of computer systems. We'll also be able to discuss both the advantages pertaining to a certain systems and also be able to use computer to accrue maximum benefits. Introduction to computer systems. Computers have made a very vital impact on society. It has changed the way of life, and the use of computer technology has affected every aspect of life. As you are watching this movie or this video, I'm sure you cannot live without your phones, iPad, tablet, or even a smartphone because of the impact of technology. People are using computers to perform different tasks quickly and easily. The use of computer technology makes what we call the advantage that we grew from technology. Now, it does not matter how small a business might be, a computer will be an essential part in that business because the computer technology will accrue to that business what we call competitive advantage. The use of computer systems in businesses has changed the way most businesses operate. And we can talk about the banking system, we can talk about the telecommunication, and we can talk about all the sectors of the economy. Computers will continue to revolutionize the methods by which business operates and manage information. Many organizations are using computers to keep the records of their customers. Banks, for instance, are using computers to maintain accounts and manipulate and manage financial transactions. The banks are also providing the flexibility of online banking, electronic banking in a whole, and then we can also talk about the SMS banking. Now let's look at the advantages, specific advantages of computer system. And I'll start with storage. The computer system provides us with a very vast storage capacity that the human brain cannot retain. There are so many things that we can save on the computer system whilst the human brain cannot retain. We started from the byte, moved to the kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, and now we are in the dispensation of terabytes. You can imagine the capacity of 1 terabyte, what it can hold. As you are watching, I'm sure you cannot retain any data worth 1 terabyte, even 32 or 64 megabytes of data will be very difficult for you to recall. Now let's look at a very simple example. Can you recall 20 of the ID numbers of your friends in the class? I'm sure certainly not, because you cannot retain all those numbers. But the computer can retain all the 40,000 students on Legon campus. And that is the capacity we are talking about. The speed and accuracy of a computer system can never be compared to a human speed and accuracy. Once technology is there, the way we do things and the way we discharge our duties are faster and more accurate. For human beings, there will be boredom, there will be stress, and at the end of the day, we may not be able to give accurate results. It also saves time, time saving, when you are using the computer system. What a click of a mouse can do to take a human being so long a time to do. And of course, that alone can save you time. The response rate for receiving any request is also faster because of the introduction of computer systems. It also enhances what we call effectiveness of any system and operation. Once technology is embraced and invested in, the effectiveness is enhanced, and at the end of the day, the results are better than without computer systems. Another advantage of computer system is what we call competitive advantage. Two different organizations, two different companies may be investing in the same commodity, will be in the same industry. But because one is using computer systems, that organization or that business will accrue to itself competitive advantage compared to the other institution or business that does not use the information technology infrastructure. And of course, can bring more customers, can bring more students, and can also create a relationship with suppliers. And that will be far better than institutions, organizations that do not use information technology. Transfer of information is also faster because at the end of the day, you have the network, you have the infrastructure. So information can be sent from one computer to the other, unlike moving from one office to the other, moving from one department to the other to disseminate information. There's also the flexibility of communication, be it email, be it text message, be it voice or data communication are all possible because of technology, information technology. Now, there is also another paradigm shift in the management of human resources. And in most texts, it is called human resource information system, a system that is used to manage the human ware of any organization. It could undertake appraisal, recruitment, and so training, and so many aspects of human development. And this is as a result of the implementation of information technology. Now, let's look at some of the disadvantages. Even though we have seen a lot of advantages, there are also disadvantages. Information technology can create unemployment. Just recently, some organizations have to lay off staff because of technology. And they argue on the point that they have the technology, and they, by a click of a mouse, what 20 staff will be able to do, that click of a mouse will do. And this will result in what we call unemployment. Technology can also result as one of the disadvantages, can also waste human time and, of course, energy. Most students go for lectures just playing with their smartphones, WhatsApping, browsing, and all that. At the end of the day, they will not get the actual lecture and they waste time. Again, you see a lot of students, and it could even be staff, playing with their phones throughout the night, browsing, surfing on the internet, and all that. And this could waste time and energy as well. Data security. We are dealing with computer systems, and data must be protected. Data must be protected, and those who access the data must be known. Unauthorized users should not be allowed into the information system environment. But because data is online, it could be hacked, it could also be cracked. So many things can happen to the data and the systems as well. And this is also one of the disadvantages. Privacy violation. Information systems and computer as a whole must be protected so that human data, human biodata, and any data about any person will be safeguarded. Because we are dealing with computer systems, it could also be altered, it could be stolen, and so many things can happen to the individual data as a result of computer disadvantages. Now, we also have computer crime. And computer crime is basically trying to violate the criminal law by using computer to either perpetrate, to prosecute, or to investigate. And we can look at it as using the computer to perpetrate crime, or having the computer being a target of crime. And if it happens that way, computer crime has been committed, and the computer can be used in all these perspectives. The health issues. You can have problem with your eyes as a result of using the computer systems. You can also have a problem with your neck. It could even be your spinal cord, your wrist, and so many health-related diseases and problems relating to information technology and computers. And these are also disadvantages of computer systems. The impact on the environment. And here, the major impact is what we call electronic waste. How to get rid of gadgets is a major problem that even the Western countries are even finding difficult to deal with. And most often than not, they try to bring the used systems to Africa. And this is a serious problem in terms of environmental issues. The computer itself needs to be learned. So in learning, you have to pay a token. It could also be the corporate institution trying to bring people to teach the staff computing. And that goes also with a cost. So training is also seen in some sense as a disadvantage to the computer systems. And of course, once your system is expanding, you need additional infrastructure. You need additional hardware. You need memory. You need so many things. And that will also come as a result of cost. So you see, you have seen the advantages and then some of the disadvantages of computer system. Now let's try and use the computer in the way that will promote human good and not to destroy others. I will see you very soon in the third session.